Shot computer sentence.
Chris Washington sparks the Bears. First he takes this one in and just kind of flips it up on the glass. Now watch the anticipation. Step in front. And he just picks it off. And I'm sure that's something he works on in practice. Just took it right in for the dunk. Chris Washington, this could be a real turning point for California as they take a four-point lead.
Lightning quick guard out of St. Bernard's High School in Carson, California.
That high school has produced a lot of fine players in a Pac-10 conference.
St. Bernard's has done to the Pac-10 what minor league baseball does to the entire major league structure. It is just a proving ground for Pac-10 players. What a basketball program they have at St. Bernard's.
Of course, Leonard Taylor went there. Corey Gaines went there, who's not playing, of course, for UCLA. You can go all the way up and down. Bobby Thompson of Arizona State. There's just a lot of people in a conference who has come from St. Bernard's High School in Los Angeles.
The chant you're hearing behind us is one side of the arena is chanting go, the other one is chanting Bears. 3:49 remaining in the ball game. It's California by 4.
Still a lot of time left. Now, UCLA needs to answer the crowd. Take your time, run your offense, and get a good shot, but they need to respond on this possession.
Many teams would just fold up their tent and pack it away under this kind of pressure. Not so with a program such as UCLA. There's Reggie Miller. 24 points already today, unable to get 26. Butler with the rebound. Washington now to Johnson. A chance to up that lead to 6 with 3 minutes and 17 seconds remaining in the game.
Strange to say this, but that's the shot I'm sure Walt Hazard wanted. He wanted Miller with his hands on the ball. Richardson penetrating. Bruins have to get it in gear now defensively. California should get it inside. Go ahead, look at Butler. Give him the ball. Give it to him.
Bears content to move the ball around the perimeter.
Also content to waste some clock, but they're looking for penetration. Well, that's not a bad shot.
Johnson over Butler. Kevin Johnson now in double figures. Reggie Miller, 26 points this afternoon. Four-point ball game to Bears.
Not a critical time of the game inside of 2 minutes.
A little over two. We got to get the right players with the ball.
What a shot. What a big, big basket by Dave Butler. 21 points for Butler. His season high, I remember, 23 against Arizona. Haley, boy, is he fouled going to the hoop. He is just level.
UCLA getting the ball inside. Jack Haley with another fine play. Nice catch and shot and foul.
We've talked so much about the 52-game losing streak that Cal has had at the hands of UCLA, but keep in mind, the Bears, Dan, off to their best start since way back in 1959. California 12-4 coming in.
And 8-0 at home. We're undefeated at home. Haley, not a bad free throw shooter. He's shooting about 70-plus for the year. They can't afford misses at this part of the game. If UCLA is going to make a run, they need to start right now. Cannot afford to come down and give California opportunities and don't score. Now, there's a take a look at what Haley's shooting at.
Five-point lead now. California, 2:03 to go. The Bruins with that trapping press. Washington got Butler breaking on the right side. Doesn't even get the ball to him.
Well, they got a little conservative that time, Phil. You referred to that. They had the opportunity, but I'm sure the clock right now is more important to Lou Campanelli than the score. He wants to waste some clock. Rod Palmer picks up a foul. It's only the fifth team foul on UCLA, so they've got another foul to take and a timeout to California.
Lou Campanelli wants to talk things over with his Golden Bears. A minute and 46 ticks. Jeer Dan, as head coach of the Golden Bears, has certainly known pressure, but it was at the opposite end of the country at James Madison University. And there's Lou Campanelli's statement. The speaker's attracted my attention, but the kids and myself aren't part of it. We haven't been here 25 years. We're just looking at it as another conference game.
Well, he referred to that in the pregame locker room, and he said, look, the sun will shine if we don't win. The only thing is, it's not going to shine as well. I'm sure he wants this win real bad, but there's a lot of games left in this Pac-10 conference, and this is just one step along the road that California has to do in order to be a contender at the end of the year. California, Phil, has made its last seven shots from the floor.
Cal for the game now hitting 56% after a miserable 40% performance in the first half. Washington, boy, he is being fucked by the freshman Rod Coleman. Now to Johnson. He is picked up by Pooh Richardson. A minute, 33 seconds remaining.
Now, ideally, Phil, if you're California, you want to run this clock all the way down to about 10, then look to go ahead and shoot. UCLA just trying to play straight up defense as California's into a little spread, and they don't want to commit any fouls on this particular trip down to court. Might as well play solid now because the clock's at 15.
Johnson, nifty bit of ball handling. Now we're inside 10 seconds on the shot clock. Down the paint he goes. Releases to Taylor. Gets Haley on his back. Should have been a foul call.
And the streak may end today.
Pooh Richardson. Bruins have got to get a shot off. We're inside a minute. Richardson lets it sail. Rattles the rim. Won't go. Taylor. Haley fighting for the basketball. And we've got a foul called on Haley. Check that. No foul call. It is out of bounds on the jump ball. And the tie-up. Give the ball to California. 46 seconds remaining, and it's the Bears by 7.
And UCLA cannot waste much time now. Now they need to foul, and look who to foul. They cannot afford to let California waste any time down 7. California's going to have to really help UCLA at this point if they're going to lose the game. The streak should end. Up 7 with the ball, and 40 seconds to go. They're going to have to miss a lot of free throws if California's going to lose this one.
Reggie Miller fouled Butler the moment he touched the basketball. Campanelli, and while he says it's just like any other conference game, you have to know deep down he is not only very aware of that 52 game losing streak, he did not want it to continue at his expense.
So, and it's not another game. Of course, he said we'll all love you if you lose, but it doesn't look like they're gonna lose. This is gonna be a win for California, and he wants to stop this streak. There's a foul away from the ball. Now California's going to ask for a two-shot foul, but of course in college it's not an automatic two away from the ball like it is in the pro game.
Richie Ballesteros indicating 1-1. So not a second ticked off the clock. Dead ball foul, 45 seconds to play. Cal 72, UCLA 65. Now make what you will of the streak coming to an end, perhaps. Perhaps more importantly, Dan Belloni, the fact Cal will now go to 5-2. UCLA drops to 3-4 in conference play.
And in real trouble, Phil, in terms of winning a conference, because you have to win some road games. UCLA has not been able to do that. And I think in the second half, you have to really credit Chris Washington on the steal. California was kind of wallowing around. Of course, there's one miss. But California was wallowing around, and Chris Washington got those two consecutive baskets to lift them.
Richardson, he's going to let it sail himself, and he fills it up.
30-minute Wood actually done an outstanding job for California, 6-for-7 in the second half, and has made a lot of critical points, and he has 18 for the game, Phil, but he's the one that really turned it around for California. Now, the game is not over yet. Even though California's in commanding position, UCLA will foul here without very much time going by, and California's still going to have to make some free throws. As you take a look at that man, Reggie Miller, who's had another outstanding basketball game for the Bruins.
Miller with 26. Keep in mind, when Miller has scored 21 points or more, UCLA, 8 wins, 2 losses. It appears as if those numbers will change a bit. 8 wins and 3 losses when Reggie has scored more than 21. 33 seconds to play. Cal 72, the Bruins 67.
And UCLA cannot be choosy. They need to make a foul quick as soon as someone gets their hands on the ball.
Foul is called. It will be whistled against Rod Taylor. Well, a streak which began back in the winter of 1961. Renny Hararias, the head coach of the California Golden Bears. The last time the Golden Bears defeated UCLA.
Of course, there's Rennie right there in a white shirt who's talking away, and I'm sure there has to be some emotion going through his mind. He knows that. He knows he was the last coach on the floor, and I'm sure he'd love to see the Bears get one. Now, Chris Washington, who's had an outstanding basketball game, still is not an especially good free throw shooter for the year. He's only 62%. It may be Chris Washington's day. He turned it around with the two steals, and he's making the big free throw. This is the one that puts it on the odd number. If he makes this one here, 52 is over.
Let it go, Chris!
Washington with 19 points on the afternoon. Rebound, UCLA. We're inside 30 seconds, 28-27. Reggie Miller lets it fly, and it is out of bounds to the Golden Bears of California. Butler, two team. The Johnson on the near side, 18, 17. Wants to get rid of the basketball, does so to Butler. Now to Washington, Hewling. We have 10 seconds to go. Johnson. And he is fouled down low by Pooh Richardson.
Take a look at Lou Campanella. Look at Lou. All right, Lou.
Just any other conference game, huh, Louie?
Right. This is just like any other ball game, huh? Look at him. All right.
Lou Campanella, his first game ever as a head coach of the California Golden Bears against the Bruins of UCLA. And he will come up a winner this afternoon. And the chant is now Lou.
And I really think, Bill, that it's a gutty effort by UCLA, though. They kept this one close in foul trouble, and they had a lot of players injured. And the Bruins made a great basketball game out of it. But the Bears had too much. Too much Chris Washington. Too much Dave Butler. Too much inside scoring. And this man right here, Kevin Johnson, has picked up his 13th point, and he's had another fine ball game.
Shot from a long way out, and the clock will stop with 2 seconds to go. The Golden Bears will have the last shot of the afternoon, and Dan, they already have the victory. The last time they beat the Bruins of UCLA. All the way back, John Kennedy was the president of the United States. Keep in mind, the San Diego Chargers, in their first year in San Diego in the AFL, had just knocked off the Boston Patriots in the first old AFL championship. It has been a long, long time. Miller lets it go. It won't go. And the streak is history.
Credit the Bears. They did what they had to do in the second half, led by Chris Washington with his fine play.
Now there is Campanella's reaction as the clock reached zero. The monkey off the Golden Bears' back. The 52-game winning streak of UCLA over the California Golden Bears is history.
Look at Lou Campanella. Just like any other game, Lou.
And the last time a Cal team posted a 13-4 start was Pete Newell's 1959-60 team, which incidentally rolled on to a 28-1 record before losing to Ohio State in the finals of the NCAA tournament. There's the final for Dan Belwamini. I'm Bill Stone. Oh, what a ball game you've just seen here on NBC.
A promotional fee has been paid to NBC by